Now, I would like them to play the footage of what you saw last night and why a lot of people are upset with me right now.
Wait a minute. This is just going to prove he's completely wrong. Everybody saw this. The world saw it. The Undertaker with that big boot. The chair right into Hulk's face. Now look. Look, he looked right over the foot on the rope. You see that, don't you, JR? He saw it plain as day. How's he going to ride his way out of this? Come on, think of a big one. Give him the whopper.
That looks like I made a bad call. It looks like I saw Austin's foot on the rope and still counted him out.
Looks like it.
That wasn't the case. Please play this next footage.
What do you mean next footage? What's this?
Well, this is, I think, the angle that Flair saw. The camera, this is Flair's perspective here. Look at Undertaker's body, King. Flair couldn't have seen through Undertaker's body. I mean,
now that
he didn't have x-ray vision.
Now that's what I saw. I wouldn't do anything in the world to hurt Steve Austin. I respect Steve Austin. I told him to his face he was the man. And he is. Hell, I like Steve Austin. Austin and I are friends. And I want to take this opportunity in front of the whole world. Because Stone Cold is in the building tonight.
Not much to your regret.
I want him to hear this from the bottom of my heart. Stone Cold, I apologize.
Oh boy.
That's the honorable thing to do.
Well, that makes it all right.
That's right. From the bottom of my heart.
Well, I think the Nature Boy is going to get the opportunity to apologize to the Texas Rattlesnake. Face to face.
Yeah.
Man to man.
Oh, this is going to be great. Yeah. If I was you, Ric Flair, I'd open up a can of haul ass right now. I'd get out of here quick. That good.
Austin didn't even lay his eyes on Ric Flair. Austin looking to...
Everybody's giving Flair the cold shoulder. Everybody's ignoring Ric Flair.
Austin, sir.
Oh, look out.
Austin very predisposed here. Normally climbs those turnbuckles and salutes the fans.
Yeah, but Austin knows that he should be the number one contender for the WWF title right now. But he knows he's not because of that man, Ric Flair. Ric Flair screwed you, Austin. You know he did.
The King, he made a bad call on Austin. Giving these fans here in St. Louis their due, their credit.
Uh-oh.
I know the WWF title means more to Austin than, quite frankly, life itself.
That's right. Get the censors ready. Look, Flair can't even look him in the eyes.
You're sorry?
Oh, boy.
You apologize? You made a mistake? You're standing right there telling me you made a mistake. Telling me you're sorry. I say you're full of crap. You come out here, showing a little footage, flapping your mouth. The bottom line is, Stone Cold Steve Austin ain't the number one contender no more. You talk about the gospel. I don't hear no church bells. And the more you sit there and whine about the mistakes you made, the more you piss me off.
Oh, run, Flair, just run. Look, you can't even look at Austin. You might as well just turn your back and run.
You said you made a mistake last night. Look at me. I said, look at me, you son of a bitch.
Whoa.
Wow, that's the owner of Raw that Austin's talking to.
Now he's looking.
You said you made a mistake last night? What? You damn right. When you screwed Stone Cold, you made the single biggest mistake of your life.
Oh boy, this is gonna be good.
And I don't care what you've done in the past. I don't care what you're gonna do in the future.
Uh-oh.
I don't give a rat's ass how many championships you've had.
Whoa. 16 championships.
Whoa.
He's a Hall of Famer.
I did not mean to interrupt you. We got to set the record straight, man. I made an honest mistake last night. I did not bring the NWO down. I am not your enemy, Stone Cold. And I sure as hell am not Vince McMahon.
Boy, they got that
right.
You
damn right you ain't Vince McMahon.
Right.
You don't look like Vince McMahon. You don't talk like Vince McMahon. You don't smell like Vince McMahon. But you know what? I'm starting to wish you were Vince McMahon. You know why? Because I'd rather deal with a sumbitch that's going to look me in the eyes and tell me he's going to screw me than deal with a sumbitch like you who's going to look me in the eyes, shake my hand, pat my back, see how good of friends we are, turn around, and screw me first chance he gets.
That's telling like it is. That's what happened.
So while I got my eyes locked on them little beady eyes of yours, and since we're standing here in my ring, and we are in Missouri, and this is the Show Me State.
Oh boy.
Uh-oh. This is going.
Since you showed me all your footage, Stone Cold Steve Austin got something he want to show you. How about that?
Look at it with your little beady eyes. That's a big deal right there, JR.
Damn right it is.
I don't blame you for feeling the way you feel. If the shoe were on the other foot, I'd feel the same way. I screwed up. I've apologized. But in one night, I can make it all right. I can do the right thing by you.
Wait a minute now, what?
Tonight, I can make sure the NWO never screws with Stone Cold again. I'm gonna take that other badass Texan, Bradshaw, make him your partner versus the NWO. That's right. Tonight, Stone Cold and Bradshaw versus the NWO. Right here in St. Louis, Missouri.
We had to go for the cheap pop, but this ain't sitting well with the rattlesnake. Look at this.
I don't know if that's going to make the rattlesnake whole. He'll look forward to a fight with the NWO. Austin and Bradshaw against the NWO tonight, but you've got to wonder what Austin is thinking.
He still ain't the number one contender.
I don't know if he bought that explanation or not.